Another game in the black, red, and yellow, and another Vancouver Canucks win. Now, I will say that I did not watch the majority of the second half of the game at home. I watched the first two periods sitting here in my chair, looking at eBay, looking at auctions, looking at other things, and avoiding my broadcast law final study material. I'm praying for a miracle that I do well on that final. But I did watch the second half of the third period and most of the overtime in a little bit of a different spot. I was sitting down in a different chair, leaned back, facing up to the ceiling, and watching the game with really strong shades on my eyes and somebody poking through my mouth with a few sharp metal steel tools, having their fingers rub along my teeth a little bit in my gums. Yeah, I was at the dentist. So I missed the first half of the third period because I left the house. I drove over to the mall, parked myself up, went over into the dental seat, and eventually turned on the TV, and the Canucks were up 4-3. And I was like, okay, that's great. And then all of a sudden, the Canucks score a goal, and that's great. And then the Sabres score two, and then it goes to overtime. And then right before JT Miller ends it, my appointment finishes up. I have to check out, pay, and all that stuff. So I didn't actually see the very prime climax of this game, but I did see enough to where I can actually give an informed opinion, I believe. So let's talk about this game. Hey, the Canucks were coming into this one. Last time they wore these jerseys, they lost in overtime to the Colorado Avalanche, and it wasn't too great. Nathan MacKinnon is an absolute beast. What a maniac that guy is. But this time, the Vancouver Canucks go into overtime again, but ultimately take the W. Now, I didn't actually see the overtime game-winning goal, so I will do that at the end of this video, probably do it live and talk about what I like about it, but for the most part, the Vancouver Canucks came out of this one really, really hot. The first period was filled with a few moments for both of these teams to actually get their zone time in and actually get their shots on goal, but the Vancouver Canucks had most of the opportunities that looked super dangerous in the first period, I believe. Lots of really good cycling and lots of really good passes out in front. There was a moment where Quinn Hughes had the puck in the offensive zone, and Hughes was setting up guys like crazy. The Canucks didn't get a goal on that play, but Quinn Hughes could have easily had like three assists or something in the span of about like 30 seconds in that one first period moment. So Quinn Hughes, he was going off, but overall the Vancouver Canucks get a pretty solid lead out of this first period off of a goal by Josh Leivo. Thank you, Toronto, because it's Josh Leivo who gets the puck after Jordy Benn sends a really long Hail Mary stretch pass right over the Canucks blue line, right through the neutral zone, and onto Josh Leivo's stick. Marco Scandella is the Sabres defenseman who pinches in to try to cut off the angle of the puck when it's falling down. Ultimately, though, the puck goes through him, it goes right to Leivo, who comes right in, takes a far side shot, and all of a sudden, Carter Hutton has let in the first goal of the game. It's 1-0 Vancouver, and the Vancouver Canucks take the lead 9-5 in the shot department to round out that period. Things were really good, and honestly, the Vancouver Canucks looked like they were buzzing. They could have scored a few more goals in that first. It's only 1-0, so the Sabres have a chance to still be in it, but this was a dominant Vancouver Canucks first period. Come the second one, things are a little bit great too, because we start things off quickly with an Antoine Roussel goal. He's the guy who has the puck, he brings it into the corner, and he drops it off. He's like, yo, Vertanen, take the puck. So Vertanen takes the puck, sends it back over to the point. Myers is there. Then Myers rips one towards the crease, where Antoine Roussel picks the puck up again and shoots it into the open cage. Antoine Roussel has his second goal in as many games for the Vancouver Canucks, an 82-goal pace if he played the full year. And all of a sudden, the Canucks are up 2-0, and Antoine Roussel is the guy who started it all. At this point, things are looking really good, and I'm like, yeah, okay, the Canucks are gonna win this one. Yeah, I'm probably gonna see the end of the third period sitting in a dentist chair, but I'm feeling pretty confident about this one. And then all of a sudden, right when I was thinking that, the Sabres score two goals in about like a minute. So, yeah. It's nice being a Canucks fan. It's Kyle Okposo and it's Sam Reinhart. Okposo gets his first goal coming back. He missed a whole bunch of games, so it's really nice to see him back in the lineup for the Sabres. And then Vancouver boy Sam Reinhart gets them on the board too. It's tied 2-2, and then going into the end of the third period, I was like, okay, we're really just gonna end this one off on a 2-2 tie. I'm gonna pick this game up and it's gonna be tied. There's gonna be nothing to talk about. We're gonna lose. Because, you know, being a bipolar Canucks fan definitely does have its fair share of weird thoughts. But right when I was thinking that, all of a sudden it's Josh Leivo. Again. This time, it's Boeser and Pettersson who set up Josh Leivo for his second on the night at 17:11 of the second period. There are a few minutes to go, but all of a sudden, the turnover comes out into the middle. Leivo receives the pass from Brock. Petey gets it. He goes back over to Leivo, and instead of going far side like he did in his first goal, he goes short side, right through the glove, right through the goalie, and all of a sudden the Canucks have the lead again. And I was like, yes, okay, great, that is exactly what we need. End the second period up by a goal. That is exactly what this team needs to develop a good mindset heading into the third and to really solidify their chances of winning this game. But then when I got to the dentist, I pulled out my phone and I saw, hey, it's 3-3. Victor Olofsson gets a goal. And I was like, really? Again? This guy? Olofsson's been an absolute beast this year. A rookie. Somebody who early on was challenging Makar for the favorite spot in the Calder voting. But Olofsson gets a really nice one-timer goal. Really weird pass, but Olofsson kind of moves his body, shifts over, opens up the angle for himself, and gets on the board here. It's 3-3 to start off the third period, and at this point, I don't actually see the first little bit. Tyler Myers gets a shorthanded goal. It's a really nice play from Pearson and Miller. Miller sends the cross crease over to Myers, who buries his first on the year. Myers didn't have a point for the Canucks in however many games he's played so far, like 13 or something straight games without an assist at least, and he gets an assist here in this game, and then he gets a goal in the third. So Myers is bouncing back on the score sheet, puts the Canucks up 4-3, it's a shorthanded goal, and then all of a sudden I turn on the TV in the dentist chair, and Antoine Roussel gets one again. This one is the really nice one, Virtanen and Stetcher involved on the play. Jake Virtanen takes the puck into the zone. He takes a low shot rebound out in front for Roussel. That's the good old NHL 17 play right there. Low shot rebound. It works virtually every time in the video game, but it works here tonight, and Antoine Roussel has 3 goals in 2 games played. That is a 123 goal pace over 82 games. Totally sustainable. Then the Canucks let up 2 goals again. Huh, it was nice watching this one in my dentist chair, because Zemgus Girgensons gets a goal, and then Marcus Johansson ties it up late. It's a 6-on-5, the Canucks are hemmed in their zone. Passing is going around everywhere, Eichel gets a nice one over to Johansson. Eichel's got 3 assists in the game, and all of a sudden it's tied, and Canucks fans I saw were like, okay, well, we lost to the Avs in overtime in these jerseys, so same thing's gonna happen here again, right? Wrong, because all of a sudden, Henry Okiharju gets himself a penalty. It's an interference call against Jake Virtanen, and the Canucks go on the power play where JT Miller seals the deal. And I actually didn't watch this goal, so let's watch it here together. Yes, okay, loading up the NHL.com video. I've been seeing tweets about people saying things like a water bottle, so I'm not sure what happens there. Brock Boeser has it, circles back over to Quinn Hughes at the top of the slot, over to Miller with a one-time. Oh my goodness, what a goal. What a freaking goal. Such a simple, cool, calm, lackadaisical looking play. Boeser spins it around. Hughes not even really moving, he just takes it, and he just sends a pass over. Miller rips it. Oh, the water bottle just shatters. What a great goal. JT Miller seals the deal. The Vancouver Canucks get a win in the retro jerseys. It's 6-5 over their expansion brothers. JT Miller gets a really nice one. And all of a sudden, the Canucks are back on top. 2 assists for Troy Stetcher, 2 points for Tyler Myers, and then the forwards got really in on it. Boeser gets 2 points. Miller gets 2 points. Leivo gets 2 goals. Roussel gets 2 goals. Virtanen gets 2 assists. And Elias Pettersson gets an assist too. Demko, he stops a total of 23 over 28 shots. Not a great save percentage on his end, but he played pretty okay for the most part. The Vancouver Canucks ultimately win this one, and I was not there to see it. Hope you enjoyed this video. Social Network 9. And bye.